I'm waiting for you, bitch. It's all on you. For all the marbles. For all the marbles! Still bitch ass. Can't lose to a bitch ass pussy. Yo, what? You hear what I said earlier? That would be funny if shit, though, if it actually happened. Like, some random girl, like, you know, Eden Williams? Or, like, yeah, no, but that'd be funny as shit, though. Like, she's just scrolling through her Facebook. And she's like, ah, bitch ass pussy comes out of nowhere. I've been ready, bitch. Thanks for the great field position, though. I appreciate it. I appreciate the great field position, as always. Yo, I should start my own YouTube channel.
You're all about the numbers, aren't you?
No, I'm serious. I should, but the thing is, I need to get, like... Oh, crap. But anyway, I need to get, what do you call it?
Look at CJ Anderson
and what a look it's going to be.
Yeah, I need to get a camera, but I also need to get a one of those things called something to record it that records it much movingly. This is touchdown, yeah. Touchdown. Yeah, no, we're not kidding you, it actually happened. I mean, how can we be kidding you when it actually happened? I mean, it happened. I mean, we're not kidding.
Where is there on the fly route? And you know how many times
no, you're not. You're not. I can guarantee you. Well, you are definitely not going to win this game. Really well. It doesn't matter if they know it's I don't give a fuck what EA says. You are not winning this game. I don't give a fuck if I get EA'd 100 times. I won't get EA'd on the one. If I don't care if I get that one play, I don't get EA'd. I'm going to score a touchdown. So. If it's 1 out of 10 times I'm getting EA'd, that one time I don't get EA'd, I'm getting scored a touchdown. Should be good. Oh, shit. All right, whatever. Still gonna beat your ass. Still gonna beat your ass. I don't care. I'm still gonna beat your ass. I don't give two fucks what you say. I'm still gonna beat your ass. Oh, and you're returning this like a bitch-ass pussy. Just like you lost 7 yards to lose. 5 yards. You lost 5 yards. That cost Seattle the Super Bowl, and that cost Atlanta the Super Bowl. 5 yards. 5 yards definitely cost Seattle the Super Bowl. 5 yards. See, touchback goes after the 25, so then you got out to the 20, so you lost 5 yards. That cost. Try running toss against this defense. Just try. I triple double dare you to try. I triple double dare you to try, and you're not. You don't even accept the challenge. Hit him. What's he?
Give him 9 on the play, and it'll be second and about a yard.
Brady. For the first. Yo, who's your NFL team? I never got that. Who's your NFL team? I never got that. I think so. Okay, well, I mean, you should be talking about my Packers then. The Redskins didn't even make the playoffs. That's the John Chungu we know. And that's the Andrew Hines we know. Making plays. Chungu, losing yards. He shouldn't. Uh-oh, he's running toss to the wrong. Oh, no! Look, good thing he ran out of bounds. Good thing he ran out of bounds. Big Don, give me that cover 4 that we had that just completely shut down this thing.
He started this drive with another big gain, another first down run. I've got to wonder if I'm the defensive coordinator. What do I do in this
give
situation?
Give me contain outside. Give me that other guy. Contain this outside.
Slow him down and make him beat me another way.
He's out of it. Oh my God, I'm so scared. There's motion. I'm so scared, Shandy. I don't know what I'm going to do.
Newton turns and hands to Stewart.
Before he's brought down. I'm still gonna beat your ass. I'm really gonna do it.
And it'll be a Carolina first. Defense showing blitz.
So good. This is the game. If you win this, I will literally call myself a bitch ass pussy if you win this game. No. There you go. Loser has to do that. Okay. Yeah.
To escape and he goes down.
Alright, let's wrap it up. I'm a pissed ass pussy. Hashtag forever. Hashtag forever. Hashtag forever.
Running left, Stewart on the toss.
Oh shit.
Enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. 14 yards there on the pickup, and all of a sudden here it's third down. And no press coverage here. They are backing off in the secondary.
Cover that other side. No. Leave. Gotta get this edge.
On third down, Jonathan Stewart.
He's shot.
It's a 5-yard pickup, but spotted a few chain links short of the first, so a little bit of decision time here coming up on fourth
down. What are you
gonna
do?
And Ron Rivera, he's gonna keep the offense on the field. They're going for it.
You can't run and sneak against this this play call.
Now a handoff here to
his you're gone, shit.
Down the numbers,
you called the right play. I'll get that deal.
Cuts it left and now room to move.
At least tackle his ass. I'm still gonna beat your ass. I really do not care. You're gonna miss this. You shot. You bitch ass pussy, baby.
A couple times in this game, I just don't know that he envisioned doing it in the first quarter.
Still gonna beat your ass. I don't really care.
I'm not sure we did, right? Because all the great ones, that's what they do. They dream about it, right? They think about it. They envision it.
I want, whatever. Thank you. Thanks for the great deposition. I'm pretty sure. Shaggy, it's not worth going onside. I'm just giving you advice. It's just not worth it. It's really not worth it. You can see, I'm going to score a touchdown this play. That's just because you're going onside. It is really just not worth going onside. And I don't want to say it. There's that touchdown. Oh, there's something. Come on. You've got to catch those.
So second and 10 here. They come out here in the eye. Now a carry. It's C.J. Anderson.
Nice double tackle. We got to break him one more tackle there. He would have been gone. Oh, my headset battery is low. My headset battery is low. I still got like 15 minutes on it. But,
How about when you put it all together as a runner and you
shit.
Can fake people out? You can
Come on.
So the offense.
You're a bit. Okay, you want to talk about being a bitch ass pussy? You are the definition of one. Oh, okay. You think I look bad? Look at your ugly ass.
And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. It'll be a 2-yard
I kicked the field goal.
And that's going to bring up a fourth down.
This is a long field goal, but I'm pretty sure I can get this.
And the field goal unit
yeah, that's good.
Nice.
Just take the knee. Just be a man. Okay, well, that doesn't matter.
And a mile high air in full effect.
I need to change the depth chart. Alright, I'm ready. Go.
As that's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Here's the Carolina offense as they get ready to take over here.
Which I'm gonna test that thing. I don't know why, but mine doesn't like. You know how like when you're trying to pause, when someone pauses and you're trying to pause back, or you're trying to go back, and it like a 30-second timer goes off. Mine doesn't do that. Like mine doesn't have a 30-second timer for some weird reason. I don't know why. Oh, damn ball! Oh crap! Incomplete. It's a bitch ass pussy play.
Alright, we got a lull here, so I want to talk about what you and I were discussing before the game. I asked you, what was the difference in the Super Bowl first three quarters versus the fourth quarter? England to have that comeback, besides Tom Brady.
I think now that we've had a chance to have more perspective, right, to step back.
Try run and talk. Like, why would anyone run talk on third down again? Except for John Chungy. It just doesn't make any sense. Spread out! Oh my god! Oh, why is pass? How do we stop this?
And by the end of the game, New England ran 93 points.
Just how?
46.
and Atlanta's defense was gassed by the end of the game. And that
I called him on play. Oh, shit.
Tom Brady and that offense of the Patriots to come back, tie it up, and then win it in overtime. So I think we kind of missed that along the way when Atlanta was riding high and controlling the ball game.
And he takes this timeout. Now the Broncos are going to take a timeout.
I think it was in big time that play I called once.
In this second quarter. And the D looking like they may blitz. There's Newton.
Get the motherfucker!
Down shy of the 45 at the 46. It's a 9-yard gain and it keeps the drive moving.
Try running toss against this shit. See what the fuck happens.
Newton on first down.
Yeah, and he still doesn't even have the guts to call toss. Oh, God, shit!
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's
shut up, Mom!
For the team that lost it to get it back.
Shut up. You're going to say that. I knew you were going to say that.
Everyone else is trying to
execute
what they're supposed to do.
I'm mad at my parents. I don't know.
In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
Stewart is the lone setback.
Mom, come on, tackle!
Before he's brought down, 12 yards there as they move the chains.
And that run was what a lot of people call an explosive run. Gave them good yardage, solid
yardage. This might be a good blade run against Toss. I found my blade. That's the judge show you. We fucking know. And that's the judge show you. We will always know. Shut up, Dad.
Your first thought is to think of run.
They're still annoying, first of all. I'm mad at them about this.
That's one of the few times they've been able to contain him. He's had a heck of a game, and maybe he's getting a little bit tired from how many times he's carried the ball.
Oh, you're damn right. Bet the pussies do get tired. Don't ever think for 1 second they won't. She's short, yeah. Alright, let's see what we got here. Nickel. He's not making this. He's definitely not making this. Oh, shit. Alright, we're good. We're fine. Thanks for the great field position. I appreciate it.
It's a lot of offense to run to only get 3 points, but they'll take
I appreciate the great field decision, Shungu. Just me, Dumpster. I mean, like, you're never going to recover an offside kick. You're going to recover it one out of, like, 10 times, and that one time is just not worth it. Touchdown. Oh, fuck it! Come on, only bitch-ass pussy's dropping. Emmanuel Sanders, he's a lot of things, but he is not a bitch-ass pussy. I'm kind of worried about this one, but I mean, we're solid still, I think. Hopefully.
That offense can put 6 on the board here. We'll see. Unable to connect on the first down pass play. Now it's second down. Play fake to Anderson. Now Simeon. He's got time. He's going to try and go deep again.
Gotcha!
And this is caught. And he is into the end zone for a Denver touchdown.
Yeah, because you're B.A.B. And this is the Panthers secondary, we know. Good? Yeah. No. I'll tell you what's bullshit. The bullshit is the fact that you have 17 points on the board. That is total bullshit. I gotta take a piss. My bladder needs to be empty for me to be totally focused.
Oh, I did. I'm back, bitch.
I'm back. Resume the game.
Frequently here in Colorado, that one over the end line, so it'll come out to the
25. Probably zero right now.
Carolina getting set to take the field. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't.
I just had Bruno Viblis again.
But they also have to remember they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
Oh, I forgot to call my ultimate stop toss play.
They'll start the drive with a run by Stewart.
Is he short? Yeah, he's short.
He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4.
2 minute warning, unless you could get this playoff.
So
yeah, 2 minute warning.
Alright,
recent plays.
They'll come out in the pistol. To throw on second down is Newton.
That's John Shunky, we know.
Hit as he throws there, incomplete.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll
remember that one time? Oh, that was funny as shit. When, we would play like a night game, and we would play like a night game, and I was the Raiders, and you were the Panthers.
Again, we'll see the pistol.
And like, I was, and like, you didn't have your mic on? Oh, I'm talking about. But anyway, you didn't have your mic on?
Timeout
that was funny as shit. I was like, oh, there's a sick test, but I was whispering. It's like, it's my parents were asleep. So I was like, and then that one shot, and then when I scored that game when he touched down, you were like, it's like, that's so weird, dude. I'm going to stay up all night probably because I woke up at 1 this morning, so my sleep's going to be very off. So I'm probably going to be up all night. I don't know why my parents didn't give me a short. Remember what happens if you lose this game. Remember that. You gotta be a man of your word, man. No matter what happens, no matter if EA gets in the way. Alright, come on, let's get this thing going into halftime.
Simeon on first down.
Oh, no, that could be picked. I hate that. You know how to do a high pass? You press L1 as you're throwing it.
Just look at the receiver and say, should have caught that when that was a drop and we just put down the offense. How about a little credit for the defense?
Oh, he was wide open. I got rid of it, but he was wide open. That's what pissed me off. He was wide open. It pissed me off the most. When he's like wide open, he gets sacked. Or like the ball is
picked up the first here on third after an incompletion.
Or you're getting hit if you throw it.
Throwing on third down, Simeon.
Oh, no! Alright, kick the field goal and be able to brag and write to the scoreboard.
And it's fourth down. So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today.
That's no good. Yeah, shit.
From 45. And that is no good. And this score will stay right where it is.
Everything my fault.
Good snap, good hold. Sometimes, though, the ball just doesn't want to go where you want it. And this one winds up no good.
Yeah, no shit. Do what that not spread out. No, he can toss it to this left side.
Now they'll run it on the toss.
No, he can't.
He went nowhere. Well, he went backwards. Back to the
half on the other
end. It's a loss of 2 there, bringing out second down.
As I watch that play unfold,
damn right now where we're dying, crowd.
Right. As a corner, you're often back there guarding against the pass. But how about that diagnosis and read and get...
Oh, I love this play call. Oh, I'm going to call this every talking... Oh, wait.
On second down, here's...
That's John Shaw, you know. Half almost over, bro.
Okay, you know my bias is about to come out here. A lot of people think that the offense is just moving in the wrong direction.
But I think I know how to stop your offense, though, so I'm not really that worried.
Defensive guy. Now, as a quarterback, third and long, you really got to rally the troops here, don't you?
Yeah, you do in a big way, and what else do you have to look out for?
Get that! Oh, I didn't believe. No, I'll take that. You got to punt this. Just don't go for this. You're just putting yourself in a dumb situation if you go for this. He wasn't that wide open.
Time on your hands, right? You end up thinking way too much, and your hands get shaky.
And yes, he's a tight end, but that's a catch.
I'm playing safe. I mean, if you fake this,
he'll send this one into the mile high air, and it's a good one. That'll be put in the books as a 53-yard punt. And the offense will take over.
All right, I'm just going to lob it up, but I don't really care.
And now the Broncos' offense, they get set to head back onto the field. And what do you think goes on here in this situation?
Hold on, I'm just going to...
You're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something? You're thinking about just starting your team.
Oh, let me check that. You're coming down. No. Yeah, thank you. Oh, that was close, though.
You may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
A play fake to Anderson. It's Simeon. Deep drop. He's going to take another shot here.
Grab it.
Thought he might have had position.
Yeah, my man should have had onto it.
Third down. Offense trying to stalling out. Facing a third and 10.
All right. But the thing is, I don't know if he comes down with that.
He's gonna go up top again.
Oh, he dropped. All right, punt. We got punt.
10 seconds now to go.
Well, they went for the big play there, but that
thing is, I don't trust my offense to get me 7 points because my offense is playing like ass right now. Then again, I was just trying to run one play. But usually that works against Stringer.
Now it's Gim.
If you return this for a touchdown, I'm going to EA and shooting everybody. Okay.
An excellent return that time.
Why did he call timeout?
And possession will change here with very little time remaining until halftime. Soft on the corners.
No, give me a different TV. Oh, shit.
First down, it's Newton. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be.
Oh, incomplete, okay.
He was trying to get it that time to 10 again.
How do I know he's trying to get it to?
They got pressure there and only rushing three.
And there's a defensive coordinator right now who is celebrating not just getting home with three there.
That's what I don't get. How did all he's trying to get it to? He's getting hit as he threw. He's going into the dirt. You're not getting this. You're not getting this, boy. If you get this, I will go to EA and literally shoot everybody who's there and shoot everybody next door and shoot everybody in that town. Okay, let's return this.
It's picked up by the Broncos.
No.
Time for a break. We've hit halftime.
Alright, hold on. You gotta see what he does before he...
This is the NFL on EA Sports.
Okay, I'm ready for you now.
This one out of the locker room, an onside kick attempt.
You're not gonna get this, boy. Don't even think for 1 second you'll get this. Yeah, thank you. Thank you for not...
Here comes the Broncos' offensive unit here as they'll have it first to begin this third quarter. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing...
No! I hate you so much. I fucking hate you. I'm still gonna win this game. I really don't care, but I hate you so much right now. Alright, send you. You suck so bad! Ah, damn. I'm still gonna win this game. I really don't care, but that was like a bitch-ass pussy EA thing. He was right up and down the backfield, and Trevor Siemian just had to throw that pick.
I'm still gonna win. Still gonna win. I don't care. But...
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six.
Thanks for the great field position. Thanks for the great field position, man. Thanks for the great field position. I'm still gonna win. This play is gonna be a touchdown. How much do you want to bet? How much do you want to bet this play is gonna be a touchdown?
Decent field position through the pick six, obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last one, that didn't bother you too much last time.
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position, not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play, too.
That's going to go as a loss of a full 8 yards. It sets him back for second down. Now a play fake, and it's Simeon. Deep drop. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And both guys were there, but it falls incomplete.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
Third and long. It's Simeon finding time. He's going to let it go again. And incomplete. He can't hang on. Would have been a nice catch. Instead, it brings up a fourth down. Here's Riley Dixon now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. Here's Ginn. 12 yards on the return that time. And the Panthers will have a first and 10 from deep in their own territory. And the Panthers coming out now. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters, as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace because you are looking for some separation.
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Now the Broncos are going to take a timeout. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. Here's Newton now on second down. Dancing to his left. Evades the tackler and now some space. He got 18 yards out of that one, and it gets him a new set of downs.
Obviously, a big play was needed, and you can see his eyes light up as he realized there's absolutely no one in front of him. And he takes off and goes a long way. Not only does he pick up a first down, but a big gain to boot.
And he's got Rome. 15 yards on the pickup there. And the Panthers are going to get a first down.
In most cases, you want your quarterback to protect himself. Slide, get out of bounds, get down. But every now and then, when he breaks a tackle, the respect level of his teammates goes sky high.
Here's Stewart, direct snap. And this one's going to go the wrong way. Losing yardage back at the 42. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down. Well, there they went blitz defensively, Charles, and things were paved well coming from the linebacker position.
I love the way that you described it, paved well. Oftentimes, the but his teammates did all the dirty work, right? They ran into people on purpose. They sometimes tugged on jerseys to hold linemen to create space and gaps. And that play finished off really, really well. Well-conceived, well-designed, and even better executed.
First and goal. They'll look to smash it in. Maybe a quarterback sneak here. And he is going to lose. And now the Broncos will burn another timeout here. So, boy, that's already the third they burn here. They are out of timeouts now before we've even hit the fourth quarter. And the coach has decided to throw the red flag. He will challenge this play. Second down, the ball on the two here, second and goal. And he takes it into the end zone for a Panthers touchdown. Cam Newton scoring on the two-yard keeper. And the Panthers add on to their lead. And maybe the defense caught a little by surprise there that he took off and got in?
Yeah, I would think so, because if you're analyzing it from that side of the ball, you're thinking running back, fullback, takes a while before he gets to the quarterback.
Well, he takes off.
Let me try to show my age a little bit. I liked it when where they would fake it from the 3-yard line, right? When you'd line up, go ahead, and oh, there's a fake, and he's going to get two. That's great. But from the 15, the best reward is just not there.
It's so risky to get 15 yards on a fake. Well, you see the result. And he lost the ball. It's picked up by the Broncos. And Denver getting set to take the field. And they're coming off a 3-and-out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't come before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before, realize it hasn't worked
so well. Go to something else.
But maybe try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area. So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
And now they're in the hurry up. Play fake to Anderson. Now Simeon. And he'll be hit as he releases it. And that'll fall incomplete. So incomplete on second down. Now they'll look to convert here on third.
We just saw another example of really good defensive football, which has led to the cushion that they have in this game. Got to him once again, knocked him on the ground, forced an incompletion.
Yeah, they've set the tone. It's one thing to set the tone, another to come in here on the road and set the tone.
All right, let's go ahead and try and get into the body and the mind of the linebackers. Yeah, I know they're bigger and stronger than I ever was, but in this situation, they understood what was going on as much as the offensive guys. Because the offensive guys always talk behind the first down stage to make the play. While defense, what they're going to do is get the first down line. Make sure they don't get there and tackle them in front. They're able to drop in their zone coverage, figure out where the first down line was, and end up making the play, swatting it away so they couldn't get the completion.
They start on the ground. This is Stewart on first. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. A well-executed blitz, no doubt. Great job by the linebacker. Maybe the quarterback, if he could have seen that, could have audibled there.
Yeah, he needed to be in a different play because that one just meshed perfectly for the defense. All the gaps were filled except for the one the offense really wanted to run through. And that was filled by a big man who would make a tackle. A great tackle. So, Brandon, when this offense gathers together to watch tape for this game, they're going to be feeling pretty good about themselves until the coaches get upset about the play we just saw. But you know their defense is going to be. But we put up big points all game long. The defense is going to win one every now and then.
Throwing is Newton. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Third down is a down. Both sides know they absolutely have to win. And the name of the game for the defense is pressure on the quarterback. But pressure on the quarterback with contact, that's how you end up winning it.
We'll call that a punt of 54 yards. Well struck. And it'll be first and 10 Broncos from deep in their own territory. Now this Broncos offensive unit ready to head back out onto the field. Now a play fake here on first down. He'll let this thing go. And that's caught inside the 35. All the way home for a Bronco score. Emmanuel Sanders, 84 yards. And the Broncos draw a bit closer. And that'll cut the lead down now to a touchdown. After the touchdown, here's McManus trying to kick it away. And you combine a big leg with a mile-high air. There's the outcome. This will sail out of the end zone for a touchback. Carolina getting set to take the field. They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to get a cushion, put people away. They want to run their offense and have it end up in the end zone.
Now they'll run it on the toss. And he's able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30. It's a pickup before and it'll bring up second down. They're going to hurry back to the line now. To throw on second down is Newton. And he's got some space here. 7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks. Back now at the home of the champs, Sports Authority Field in Denver. It's the Panthers out in front and in control of the football as well as we begin quarter number four. So here we go, first and ten now. And some extras coming up on the line here, readying for the blitz. Defense really showing respect to the deep ball here, playing off the receivers. Toss right side to Stewart. Looking to find a lane, but he can't, reined in at the line of scrimmage. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine. And in this situation with a lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. Six, seven, eight, nine.
Down he goes. Tough to handle on that blitz. He gets him for a loss of five. Man, he got in there so quickly, Charles. What could the offense have done to adjust and account for that?
But what you're hoping is that you figure out and you see and get a clue that maybe there's going to be some pressure coming at you. And you change the blocking schemes. Maybe you go to max protection. The biggest one's maybe when you're running back in to try to keep it clean. But in that case, that didn't happen. Zero accountability and a sack resulted.
Offense is not leaving the field. They're going to stay out and go for it on fourth and three. And he's got a first down as he's up to the 48. Call it a gain of five. And on fourth down, they're able to convert and move the sticks.
You know what? Now and then it pays to take chances in this league. You can't play everything by the book. You're on your own side of the 50, but all you need is a few short yards, and they're able to convert to keep the drive going.
He's going to run again. Looking for a crease, can't find one. Stopped at the line of scrimmage. The safety, TJ Ward, in on the stop.
Drive
coming up, and certainly not an easy one on third and long. Now they'll run it on the toss. Call it no game there, and it leads to a fourth down.
One thing I love about this game is there's a match of wits throughout the game. Who's going to get the advantage? Who's going to catch someone off guard? Like the offense thought they might catch the defense off balance with that play call, but unfortunately, that didn't work for them.
Now let's see. Yeah, the offense still out there. They elect to go on fourth and 11. The Panthers going for it on fourth. Yeah. And the Panthers turn to run. The Broncos are going to get the football back in great field position. Boy, you talk about not playing it safe. Why were they going for it there, Charles?
It's got to be a full evaluation of their team. Do they trust their defense in this situation? Maybe they think they've given all they can in this game and they don't have anything left. Do they not trust
that? It's intercepted. It's picked off. And the return goes up to his own 17-yard line. And they're definitely showing blitz here. Throwing here, Newton able to shake him off, eluding the pressure right. No gain, and it's second down.
Well, the defensive guys won't be real happy because there won't be a sack on this play because he did get back to the line of scrimmage. But what a job they did overall. Hemmed him in and gave him nowhere to go with the football.
And they're going to speed things up here. it's Newton. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
And he still doesn't have a catch. We're into the second half. I think it's a little bit of a surprise to me, but that was one he should have caught.
Absolutely. That was his best opportunity right there. He dropped it. And no press coverage here. They are backing off in the secondary. And some changes here as the D-line separates some. Now flags will come in. This one's going to be on the defense for jumping. He may try and run for this. And some room to work. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. And he goes for 18 there as the drive will continue.
And while it's highly unusual for NFL teams to think about using their quarterback on key third down runs, none of those teams save one has Cam Newton. He's unique, one of the biggest quarterbacks you'll ever see. Give him the ball, let him pick it up.
It's going to go as a loss of six, and it'll set him back for second down. Another run for Stewart. He's been busy. And he is going to lose yardage here. Now goes a loss of five. And they're going to be standing at a third and one.
Let me talk out my chest a little bit, even though I'm not rooting for either team. That is a really nice defensive team. It's awfully fun to watch, even in an offensive game.
Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first. They've got two more to use
during
the final stages.
I'm not touching it. You did not win this game. You did not win this game.
Now the defense definitely showing blitz here.
Oh, no, no, that's disrespectful, bro.
An encroachment penalty here, maybe just a minute lapse, partner.
Sometimes you have to just watch the football. Make sure it's snapped.
That is so disrespectful. You do not do that shit. No, 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 no.
So the D-line is going to spread
out. Oh, my God, you are so disrespectful.
Now contact up front as penalty markers come in. Who is this against?
You are caught in play. Don't give me that shit.
Just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play.
Fuck you, Dad. Shut up.
The Panthers down to a knee out of the victory formation. So nursing a slim lead, and that is the opposite of protecting that slim lead.
All I can think here is that head coach, he knows more about what's going on with his team than we do. He must know something's up. Either he has trouble with his punter, right? He's worried about his...
And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And that is going to seal this victory as time runs out.
He ain't won you that, no. No, he ain't won you. No, no, he ain't won you that. No, 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 he ain't won you that. Alright, I'm not doing that. Here's the thing. He ain't won you that fucking game. He ain't won you that game, and I don't give a fuck what you said. He ain't won you that game. I did not do that. And we are having a rematch right this fuck now. I'm going to disconnect your PlayStation 6. We are having a rematch. We are having a motherfucking rematch. But I'm going to disconnect your PlayStation.
I'm disconnect your PlayStation. He's not gonna happen. This next game, I guarantee you, whatever what happens, I will post it. But I did not lose this game. EA won this game for you. EA won this game for you. You had nothing to do with it. That was all EA. EA, left and right. The next game we could do. But that was all EA. EA. I don't give a fuck what you say. This next game we play for all the marbles, I don't give two fucks. But that was all EA. I don't give a fuck what you say. No, alright, now disconnect your PlayStation thing. They're playing it, you bitch-ass pussy! Madden NFL. Enjoy the rest of your afternoon, everyone, as we say so long. Very funny. You're a very bad motherfucking liar. You're a bitch-ass pussy. I'm gonna fuck with EA shit. This next time, I'm gonna be pumped up and I'm gonna play. I'm not gonna broadcast this shit. I'm putting on my music. I'm putting on my motherfucking music! Yeah, I did. Finish the motherfucking game. We are motherfucking playing again, and I don't give a fuck. This is the game, it's the Super Bowl. I don't give a motherfucker what you said. This is who's the better Madden player, and we can pick any team we motherfucking want. I'm putting on some motherfucking music. I'm putting on my motherfucking music. I'm recording this fucking shit. Fucking bullshit. This is the motherfucking Super Bowl. I can pick any other motherfucking team you want. Pick whatever you want. Pick the Panthers, pick the Cowboys, pick the Falcons, pick the Giants. What? I'm picking the Falcons. Can I play as the Falcons? Yeah. You know what? Screw it. I'm going as the, what's the team I always choose after? Hey, why don't you go as the Patriots and I go as the Falcons? Patriots, you go as the Falcons. This is the Super Bowl! Motherfucker, doesn't matter who wins, this is the Super Bowl! And whoever loses this game has to post their bitch-ass pussy on Facebook. And no matter what EA says, last game was EA, but no matter what EA says, no, the last game was all EA. That was all EA. There was a bunch of, that was all motherfucking EA. There was no motherfucking, there was motherfucking EA. Motherfucking EA. I was pressing a goddamn button, and nothing fucking happened. Nothing fucking happened. I was pressing the triangle button, he was right there, and he couldn't make the pick. I was pressing the hit stick button, and he just stood there and did nothing. That was not my motherfucking fault. Well, you're damn right we're not gonna die tonight.
Sign there as his guys will get it at the 25.
No matter what happens in this game, I swear I will post it if I lose. Motherfucking Super Bowl. Motherfucking who's the better man or player? I'm fucking pissed right now. Skateboard!
The D swarming to the line. Throwing now, Ryan on first down.
Get that! There's a motherfucking person, motherfucking shot there!
The Pro Bowl wideout Julio Jones is intended receiver. And that'll bring up second down. And the Buffet Boys, the O line. Hopefully they're ready today.
Yes, coming from Matt
Hill. If you do, you usually get a great product out on the field. And when they play well, the quarterback can't wait to feed them afterwards. Again on second and 10, it's Ryan.
Take that! Oh, fuck, that's all he is. But I don't give a fuck. We don't need it. We don't need it. We don't need it. The MS is up here. We don't give two fucks. It's about who's being a better player. Who's the better man player? This is the Super Bowl. This is for all the marbles.
Yeah, and if you watch the game unfold, which I know you did.
And nobody comes into this house. No, non-bitch-ass pussy, not a bitch-ass pussy without paying the price. Especially bitch ass pussy. Oh shit, he might be gone. And he is. Fuck you. 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 Alright, stay out the way. Yes. You didn't get in.
A big run there by Freeman. 63.
That should have cost you.
And Freeman, not sure if he was a surprise exactly, but he sure took the NFL by storm.
But when you talk with his team, they'll tell you they saw this coming. They knew he had the talent. They were just ready to.
We were on top here. What kind of? Yeah, we had him on the edge, though. We had him. Come on, you've got to make that tackle. You're going for two. This is the Super Bowl. Might want to get those two extra points. Because I'm going for two every time. I'll just say that right now.
And they do exactly what they wanted to. Opening drive, they get into the end zone. They do it on the ground.
And not only is the person lugging the ball happy, of course, because he got it into the end zone. How about the offensive lineman and receiver?
Oh, shit. We should get this. We should get this. Yeah, we got it. All right, thanks for the great field position. I appreciate it. I appreciate the great field position. Thank you so much. I appreciate it. No, no, I got rid of that. 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 Yeah, no, but you know what happened in the real Super Bowl? Patriots had a big lead, and then the Falcons had a big lead, and then they collapsed. Cut! Yeah, that's the John Chuggie we motherfucking know.
A big shot towards the end zone.
You like that shit, don't you? Oh, fuck. Oh, fuck. All right. We should score here. We're good.
He is not getting in. What a play.
Not only stopping him at the line, but pushing him back a yard as well. Second and goal from the 2 yard line.
Can we get in here? Yeah, touchdown. Let's go. No. You know what's BS? The fact that you beat me last time. That's so BS. That's the definition of motherfucking BS. Oh my god, he's wide open! What the fuck? Alright, whatever. He's wide open! I was pressing the goddamn button. That's what pissed me off the most. I'm pressing the goddamn button.
The old school mindset says, if you have a better
return this, return this. I fucking motherfucking triple double the fucking dare you.
If you don't think you're quite as good, you have to try and take advantage of opportunities. And finally, I just think this is analytics.
Yeah, have you ever seen Ted?
Someone saying the more you go for two, the better.
Have you ever seen Ted? Ted, with the teddy bear. That movie with the teddy bear. The movie with the teddy bear. Is that funny as shit? Because I haven't seen it yet.
The drive will start with a carry by Devontae Freeman.
What about the second one? Is that any good, or is the first one better?
And they'll get this up over the 25 to the 26.
What was better?
75 yards for Freeman in the game against New England, but remember,
well, if you had to choose one.
On the first carry, he had a good second carry, but then they didn't use him a lot late.
Yeah, I saw them getting to the perimeter early. You see how they stretched out New England's big defensive line?
Get the motherfucker! Thank you!
Inside, but a lot of people think maybe they didn't run the ball enough in the Super Bowl and maybe even eat some clock, especially with the lead that they had. But they also were able to use Devontae Freeman in a passing game. Remember late?
I'm still going to beat your ass. I really.
And threw it to the flat, and he got a big play that way as well.
And I found a play to stop talking.
They come up in an offset eye.
You need to.
This is Freeman on first and 10.
You need to shut up.
Push forward for about four down to the 37. Two Patriots there to bring him down. For the Patriots,
I found my play.
Super Bowl. Yes, a rough start for this group, but they pitched a shutout in the end while Tom Brady and company were making that comeback.
They really got their legs under them in the second half, didn't they? Because they really shut them down. And Trey Flowers, defensive lineman, 2.5 sacks.
So I'm going to talk. Just see what the fuck happens. I want you to. I triple double dare you to run talk. Oh, shit. You're short.
Call it a gain of four there, so it sets up a big play here. Third and a yard.
Today's NFL, you hear all the time about stretching the field and creating space in order to run plays. A toss play will help accomplish.
Oh, no, you did it. You did not, Shungu. Oh, fuck you.
All the way to the edges and to the sideline. That's a nice run. Probing
down. Oh, no! Yes, you're straight. You're my best shot. Now you did it. That's what you do, Shungu. That's Andrew Hines football. You're not getting this. You are definitely not getting this. Don't even think for one second that you're going to get this. You call it fake, you're fucking toast. Yeah, short. Yes.
Juice and ambitious effort.
Make that shit, boy!
And this score will stay right where it is.
Well, this winds up an empty possession. Everything looked okay. He just never got the ball on target. And knowing him, he'll be disappointed with that effort.
On play action, now Brady. And he dumps it off to Blunt.
Yeah, that's a bitch-ass pussy. Yeah, you think I'm a bitch-ass pussy? You think I'm a bitch-ass pussy? We both agree, whoever loses this game has to, you know, like admit they're a bitch ass pussy and post it on Facebook. I don't, if EA gets involved, we don't give, I don't give two fucks. Alright, incomplete.
But I think it's safe to say that pressure
can
get to any quarterback.
I don't care.
Great franchise quarterback, but felt the pressure, threw it incomplete. Brady again here on second and 10.
Oh no, he dropped it.
Gronkowski, the intended target.
I thought he caught it off a rebound.
Third down.
That would have been sick, yes, I'm still going to beat your ass. I really don't care.
And bats it away.
Why did you go for that field goal, though? I mean, you suck at kicking field goals. You're even worse than me. Oh, no! Oh, shit! Just try to force that one to Gronkowski.
So good for three quarters of the Super Bowl, Charles. At one point, the advanced metrics had them at a 99.5% chance to win. It just seemed like everything was going their way, and then the fourth quarter happened.
I think when we review this game and we say, okay, where did it get away from the Falcons? What was the number of plays
that they did? Oh, my God! Oh, okay.
The Falcons ran 46. So they wore down their defense on that one. But look at what they did on offense. They were averaging big-time yardage running it, passing it, had everything going.
Called the wrong play, but that doesn't matter.
25-point lead should still be enough to win the Super Bowl.
Right it should.
9 yards per pass for the Falcons. Second down here after the incomplete pass.
All right, start running toss. Just see what the fuck happens. Well, we should wait till I win.
And he'll get
Lights are on, and then we can sing that song.
The pickup there, so it leaves him needing a conversion here on third and a tough nine.
Well, that's not a run that's going to make any of the highlight tapes, but they've been moving it well all game on the ground. This is another one that keeps them.
Give me outside the tank. Give me this.
On third down, Ryan.
Incomplete. That's the John Chugger we know. That's what John Chugger would have done. Would have dropped that pass.
Well, we're not playing 3 yards in a cloud of dust football anymore. I kind of get why those old school coaches sometimes didn't want to throw.
One of my favorite things about Coach Warner. One of my favorite memories. When he told you to move to tackle. That was my favorite memory. Yeah. Because, yeah. Take a point. Yeah, Chunky, I'm telling you as a friend, don't go for it on fourth down. It's just dumb. I'm not talking to you as a bitch ass pussy or whatever you want. Be aggressive!
Chris Hogan, undrafted, he ends up having 180 yards in receptions.
All right.
20 yards or more against the Pittsburgh Steelers. And how about James White, a fourth-round pick out of Wisconsin? Think about who he played behind while he was at Wisconsin, and he turns out to be the unsung hero of the Super
Bowl.
Touchdown!
Oh, he would
have been the MVP if it wasn't for Tom Brady.
All right.
You mentioned James White at Wisconsin. He was behind who? Melvin Gordon and Monte Ball, right?
That's correct. I'm not quite sure how he wasn't able to hold on to that one in the end zone. A great opportunity lost, but a lot of relief for the defensive guys. When they get in the film next week,
oh, shit.
They want to know what happened.
All right, do I have the length to kick a field goal for? I'll try. I mean, I don't trust this offense for shit, so.
So on fourth down, Brady will yield to Gostkowski for the field goal try.
Should be good. We got it. Stop it!
The offense got the ball in a good spot.
Yeah, I'm good at kicking long field goals, but I suck at kicking short field goals.
Major disappointment. Had a great opportunity, excellent field position, and did not be able to move the ball at all. Big time letdown.
You're damn right.
For three, now he'll kick this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback.
And the other thing is, we can't bitch out of a. We got to play this game to the end, don't matter what the score is.
And on that last drive, went for it on fourth, turned it over. Good job by their defense.
This is a Super Bowl.
Three, but this offense, they've got to be a little bit better, a little bit more careful here.
Hey, you're a business, but you should have.
On fourth down, when they decide to go for it, it's not necessarily the coach saying, I believe in my offense. Sometimes the coach saying, I believe in my
offense. Oh, no, you got to spread out.
Go for it here, because if we don't get
it. I'm stuck on this player. It's a glitch.
And that's exactly what happened.
You think that factored in?
I do. I think that he had that in his mind going into the game, that I'm going to be aggressive on offense because I know I've got a chance that can hold up their end.
5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
And that's exactly what
you know what's going to be the most lit part about BC? We play BCC. That's going to be lit. Can't wait for that. It's rumored, but I'm pretty sure it's going to happen. That's what Dawson told me. But it's rumored. What?
8 yards on the pick up there, and it moves the sticks.
Yeah, I know.
That runs the toss and runs it successfully. That means they win the battle.
We're going to play on the beach if it's true.
In order to let your back get to the
corner. That'll be sick as fuck.
Nice game.
And he'll get this up past the 45 to the 47. 9 yards is the pick up there, and they'll have a second and one.
Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
Freeman, the lone man in the backfield. He's
going to
get the
ball. Yeah, no! Short.
They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third.
I don't know about you, Parker, but I'm rubbing my eyes after that play. Did we just see that runner not get yardage?
I knew Coach Warner. I knew his brother, like, really well. Yeah, like, I feel sorry for him. The funeral is on Thursday at 6. You want to go? It's at that golf club on the Capitol Crescent Trail, you know. Oh, shit. You're gone. Still won it. I'm still won. Oh, no. I'm still going to win. I'm going to look at it. Yeah.
this first half. And the Falcons have retaken.
Shut up. That's enough of that song. Trust faith in this shit and see what happens. I'm still going to beat your ass. I really don't care. I'm still going to beat your ass. I'm still going to beat your ass. I really do not care. I really do not care. Boy, this got your Super Bowl feel to it.
Keep trying to put the pedal to the metal here. They're going to try an onside
kick. All right, I got to get my onside kick there. Thanks to the great field position, Chungu. I appreciate it. I appreciate it. I appreciate it. There we go.
Sorry, that was long. Kick there that failed. Is that something that maybe they had dialed up before this game started?
It feels like it, doesn't it? That they thought they had.
Yeah, if I were a Falcons fan, I'd be crying after that Super Bowl. If I were like a diehard Falcons fan, I'd be crying. I would not be joking. I would be crying. I cried when the Seahawks beat the Packers in that championship game because that was ridiculous. That was motherfucking. That's what you call the definition of. The football gods just hitting on you. He catch that? No. Oh. I'm just trying to force balls down the field, but for some reason it's not working. All right, enough of that song, Chungu. Ah, shit. We gotta go for this. We're in no man's zone. We're going no man's zone. We're in no man's zone. We're in no man's zone. I gotta go for this. No, I'm punting. I got punting. I can't see that. Pussy.
He really wasn't. Maybe an example of having. And how about this? A fake.
Oh, I thought that was gonna go incomplete and throw into the dirt. You have to admit that was sick. You have to admit that was sick. You have to admit. That was sick. Great. Alright, I hate your ass.
It's 2-minute warning time here. The NFL on EA Sports.
Alright, shut up! Enough with that song!
Second down. They slot Gronkowski outright. Brady to throw on second down.
Be aggressive, Gronk! Oh, man! I fucking hate you.
Ricardo Allen with a pick. And a big turnover there as his guys...
Shut up. That was EA. That was nothing. That had nothing to do with you. That had nothing to do with Brady. That was EA.
They did it all on the ground, Charles.
You can't lose to a bitch-ass pussy, especially twice in a row. It's not going to happen. And I have to post on Facebook that I am a bitch-ass pussy. We're not doing this, Andrew. Look at me, Andrew.
Other people have to get involved as well. Your wide receivers, your tight ends, lead runners, anything that you have possible to get in front and keep the ball moving. And now the defense may be looking out for a pass coming up. They'll run with Freeman here to begin the drive. Down here at the 28.
God damn it. I'm just getting EA left and right. That's what pisses me off the most.
It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Again, they'll run with Freeman. And he'll get
it to
the 33-yard line. They get five out of that one, and it moves the chains. Not too many more.
All right. I'm going to get off the mic because I need full concentration. Alright, then turn, then stop doing that, God.
And they're gonna go soft on the corners. Defense and some changes here as the D line separates some. They toss to Freeman. Oh, good hurdle.
No! Fucking hate you.
And he cuts left and he's got an alley.
Down the one.
Now whistles blow and the Patriots are going to take another timeout.
That one yard cost to Seattle the Super Bowl. So.
As we head toward halftime. And now a first down
following
that long
game. Stop that song. Just concentrate. All right.
It's Coleman here. And he will take it in for a Falcon touchdown.
I need to concentrate. I need to get off the mic.
Touchdowns, and the Falcons will add on to their lead. Bryant now to tack on the extra point. And this one gives his guys a 12-point lead. Boy, I guess they're going to keep trying to put the pedal to the metal here. They're going to try an onside kick. And this is secured by the Patriots. Out comes the New England offense to see what they can do this time. And two interceptions thrown here in this first half. You hear it, no matter the sport, they say the great athletes, they can kind of have a short-term memory, but that's easier said than done.
It is easier said than done, but I played with a guy who threw two interceptions in the first quarter of a really big...
My headset has to charge anyway, so...
Stop.
Game we were playing.
Johnny Unitas.
And no, not quite of that level and not of that age. But I remember
going for the age.
I remember looking over at him and he was smiling. And I thought, what is he smiling about? It's because he had enough confidence in himself that was a fluke. And he went out and played pretty well the rest of the day.
To throw is Brady. He's going to go for a big play downfield. And he's unable to grab it. Thought he might have had position. Couldn't hold on. Third down.
Sure, that pass was incomplete as they made an attempt to get a big one downfield. But that's okay because the second part of that is if you don't get the completion, at least you've told the defense you're trying to stretch them out a little bit, and they may have to change accordingly.
Unable to get it to Gronkowski that time. And it's fourth down.
When you see passes knocked down by those guys I call the frustrated fullbacks, the linebackers, you know that in their zone coverage, they were able to drop, see the ball thrown, and react to it very quickly.
Brady to throw for it on fourth down. And he will find his man. That's Hogan complete. It'll be a 20-yard gain on the play. And they're able to move the chains as they convert on fourth and long.
Brandon, I have one word for you after that completion for a first down.
Lucky?
Analytics.
Well, the analytics say they punt the football there.
So we're changing the analytics as we go, right? What a big-time play for them. And really took a big-time chance.
Yeah, big-time first half chance.
Partner, we know Julian Edelman's always a big part of the game plan for New England, and it was no different in the Super Bowl. They targeted him 13 times. He only had 5 catches, 37 yards. But did he make the catch of all time in the Super Bowl, that 27-yard juggling, incredible, defying catch?
You know what's impressive is they got that call right on the field. And when I saw it live on television, you were there in person, I thought, that's not a catch. But then they showed the replay. Unbelievable.
And when the official ran in and was emphatic that it was a catch, I thought he meant interception at first because there were so many red jerseys around Edelman. And as it turned out, they nailed it. Got it right on the field. Got it right in replay. And Julian Edelman had a big impact on the Super Bowl with that catch.
Gostkowski now after the touchdown. He'll send this one away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll probably wish he reconsidered here. It'll cost him 10 yards.
On the back.
I heard you. I heard you. Get out of here.
I'm back. Sound good? I'm back. Yeah.
Yards now with a new rule as he's down at the 15-yard line.
You're a bitch. You're supposed to say what? Ah. Shango. Bitch is supposed to say what?
Oh no, you're not gonna fall for it. Oh, shit.
Now the pitch to Freeman. Room here to run. And he'll get this up to the 30-yard line.
All right, Chuck, if you don't, you gotta stop that song, man. You gotta stop that song. That song is for my victory. Well, I'll play it when I win this game.
Freeman again, a first down carry.
No! No! Fuck you! Fuck you! Fuck you! Fuck you! I fucking hate you! That's all your guys' fault. Don't blame any of that shit on me. Kick the fucking ball right this fucking inch.
Say it, that can totally change the complexion of half number two.
Yeah, it changes your morale, changes your outlook.
What?
But even before that,
thanks for the great field position. I might be able to get a Hail Mary. Do on the kickoff, field goal.
Because you don't want to give up a big play right before the half ends.
Good point. And this is secured by the Patriots.
All right, let's see if we can get a Hail Mary. The Patriots. You know what's funny is that you're winning. That's what's funny. That's what's funny.
Just out of field range, could be Hail Mary time.
And haven't we seen in recent years that the Hail Mary seems to be more successful in the NFL than before?
Absolutely, we have. That is knocked away and incomplete.
I got it.
So two quarters down, two remain. Charles and I return after the break. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. And how about this line out of the locker room? An onside kick attempt. And this is secured by the Patriots. The Patriots gearing up to go now. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there. But this is a real, I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them.
When defenses get to the quarterback that quickly, a lot of times it's called a jailbreak. It wasn't quite that fast, but fast enough that he had no time to look downfield and set himself to throw the ball. And as he tried to do that, he was hit and it forced an incompletion.
Goes right side, complete to Gronk. Just a 5-yard pickup, and it leads to fourth down.
Well, there it is. Brady connecting with Gronk, but at this stage of the game, this is kind of late for them. I'm used to this happening right out of the gate.
Yeah, we were thinking we would see this per usual first quarter, definitely second quarter, but not the case.
And their offense, not moving the ball like they normally do. They're losing the game. Those two need to get together and fast.
Here's Brady to throw. This is caught. It's Julian Edelman. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 15. A big play that time on the catch and run. And they're able to pick up the conversion here on fourth down. Into the red zone, it's Brady. And this is caught. It's Edelman. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. And the offense moving quickly to the line. The former 7th-round pick, Julian Edelman, just has a man, and it's Edelman for the Patriot touchdown. Julian Edelman, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Patriots are back within a score. And this one through the uprights and good. Gostkowski now, after the touchdown, he'll send this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. A look at the offense now here, coming back out on the road for their first possession of the second half. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop him from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch counter punch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got to a good rhythm. You see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
You love pressure.
I love it.
We'll see if they dial it up this drive. It's a loss of two. Now third down.
Well, Brandon, he's had a great day. And sometimes that just happens. It is the NFL. They will make some plays against you.
So a third and nine and six defensive backs out there in the dime.
Controlling the passing lanes.
It'll be a gain of five and the punt team will now come out on fourth down.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
NFL teams last year, a little under 50% on fourth down conversions. This is a bit tougher. Fourth and four. They'll run for it. It's Freeman. And he'll get this up only to about the 33. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And the Patriots take over. They're going to have terrific field position. The Patriot offense now set to come back out onto the field. And they're going to need another score. Got one last time, but still down here.
When you're playing catch-up, every possession becomes crucial, doesn't it? It's vital. Get back out on the field, punch in the end zone again. They know it's not easy, but what they do have going for them, they did score the last time. They think they've got a good formula working.
And what a big body going to be intercepted a third time. A great read, and it's picked off. Here comes the Atlanta offense now ready to take over here. And this offense last time turned it over, went for it on fourth, didn't get it. They're lucky, though, because no points against the team on the board, but we'll see how they respond.
Yeah, they've got to get a lot of credit to their defensive teammates, don't they? They had their backs on that last series, and because they did so, that allows the coach to still stay aggressive on offense and maybe go for it again in a similar situation.
I was going to say, maybe makes that offense feel good, but when you know you've got a defense. Now we're going to get a timeout here called by the Patriots. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. Again on second and 10, it's Ryan. Into a double team and it's intercepted. It's Matt Ryan picked off by Logan Ryan. And his guys are going to get the football at the 23-yard line. Now the Patriot offense set to take over again. And three interceptions in this game. I would have to think, I wasn't a quarterback, but number four is kind of, oh, you're like, oh man, I can't throw four. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Patriot touchdown. 23 yards for the touchdown. And the Patriots have retaken the lead. As a former DB, you might not like to see that, but from a wide receiver's perspective, those are the plays they dream of.
Correct on both counts. All right? Because once he took off, I mean, let's face it, that should have been done in Big Sky Country.
Then you like that?
There, and off Check he it. Went. Glad I wasn't the one trying to chase him.
But I thought you would. And where's that pitch as pussy song? Because I'm going to say it soon.
He'll send this one away. Fielded about a yard deep.
Oh, Ethan's not going?
He won't. He'll go down to a knee and they'll start.
Yes!
From the 25.
That's how I said that.
Atlanta now coming out on the
field. Oh, we need more money then from these people.
One play interception, so this offense, they should be fresh.
What about Sue? I thought she told me she was going like literally after you said she wasn't.
Play drive where you throw an interception. A lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give him a chance.
Maybe play action.
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in it.
He's not. The reason why he's not going is because I think his mom told him he couldn't, something like that.
A 20th carry now for Freeman.
Because he didn't want his, you know, I don't know, but my parents said that, like, if their parents hear about, like, I don't know if this is true, but if their parents hear about this shit, like, hear that, like, that they're just in a house full of 20 people, then they might not let them go. But I don't know how true that is. Like,
and once again, leverage wins. The offensive line, lower than the defensive front,
They moved him and found some good space for the guy carrying the ball.
So they're going to come to the line here, and it appears trying to go for it on fourth.
Oh, he's running toss. I got it. Shit. All right. We're still going to win, but makes it tougher. We got one safety back there in case he breaks it. In this middle. We got that outside. Nice tackle.
A gain of 3, second down. And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here.
All right, you got this outside.
They've been able to move the ball really well on the ground the entire game.
And a third. Last quarter, Shungu. Who's the better mountain player? Last quarter.
Back now in Foxborough. It's been a very hotly contested
game. Sean, yeah, you're getting like a fantastic pussy. That's where you are. You're
and they're going to go soft on the corners. They come out with one back and three tight ends. Now they'll throw it with Ryan.
And hey, but
hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Well, that plays a statistic that's going to go on the defensive team stat sheet. Won't necessarily reflect in ours, right? The overall game sheet. But you and I know that they keep count on pressures,
that Mike.
Hits on quarterbacks, all those things, hoping to increase that throughout the game. And here we are in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, throwing this ball.
Such a close game, a very big one. Ryan.
Short.
Get up to the 43-yard line.
All right, come on. What are you going to do? This is the Super Bowl.
And it'll be fourth down.
And partner, I would guess that in his headset he was hearing from his coach, it's third down, don't take a sack. And in this case, he's able to avoid the pressure and get out of there. He doesn't get the first down, but he does turn a possible loss into positive yardage.
They come up in an offset eye. Back to the ground.
Oh, man, tackle!
Devontae Freeman.
That's the thing. Thank you. Great game, Shanky. But that's it. So, this play's going to be a touchdown.
Brady now on first down. He's going to air it out deep for Hogan.
Oh, he jumped it.
The collision there jarred the ball.
Thought that play would be. Well, anyway. Still going to score.
One of the toughest things about playing defensive back is pattern reading, trying to figure out what they're doing. And on that one, they had the fly, just sending the guy downfield with the in route accompanying it, what people call a dagger route, trying to hit the guy underneath.
Oh, is that you? Yeah.
In this case, though, they're not able to get it done.
Thanks, Shanky, for jumping offside. I appreciate it.
They went for the guy on the fly, but
I appreciate it. Give me 3-5 yards.
5 yards left for the offense. It's second down. Now a play fake. Brady. He's going to try and go deep again.
And both
falls incomplete.
Have to give a lot.
Oh, we got a goal for this. We're in no man's zone.
They were prepared.
No man's zone means it's like too far for a field goal, but too short for a punt.
That's usually a mismatch that the offense is used to winning. But the preparation showed for the defense, and they were able to bat it away.
Oh, okay.
Almost intercepted it. They're just forcing it into too many tough spots. That was almost a
four. How long field goal would this be? All right, we can get this.
Now fourth down.
I really do not want to do this, but we can get this. We have no business doing this.
So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This from 54.
Should be good. It's not going to matter.
Kowski's kick is good. And high fives for that one as that drive ends in three.
I'm so good at the long field goals, but the short field goals, I'm like at it. I don't know why. That's just... Oh, yeah, Brett.
If they'd gotten six out of that drive, this would be a much different game.
That'll be taken in the end zone. And they'll put up the stop sign there as his guys will get it at the 25. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And last time went for
it. Game's over.
Didn't get it. Let's see if they can pick themselves up off the mat and do better this go around.
Sometimes I have this vision.
That
Sometimes that man says, be aggressive, stay aggressive.
Maybe that's what. Oh, shit, you're gone.
Pass the 20. Touchdown, Falcons. Julio Jones.
Please miss the extra point. I'm begging you to miss this. You suck so much.
And his kick is good.
Score by my ass, bitch.
Boy, figure this one out. Leading here in the fourth. And now they're going to try an onside kick. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense.
You didn't accidentally do that. You wanted to switch the kickoff. You did not do that. You did not accidentally do that. You wanted to switch the kickoff. Don't lie.
Now after the touchdown, it's Boucher to kick it away. Now,
come on, Lewis. Come on, Lewis.
And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. And now out come the Patriots. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here.
All right, let's see what we got here.
Out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them want to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you met fan bases that wanted that, that weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants a drive to end with a kick, other than the extra point. That's it.
He's be aggressive, be aggressive. Come on, Gronk, touchdown. That was awesome, you have to admit. That was awesome. You have to admit. Come on. Send it. Say it. Say it. What?
Two-point conversion, and that score gives us our sixth lead change of the game.
Alright, thanks for going offside. That makes the PAT so much easier.
Up and down, up and down. What a game we've watched here.
It's been fun.
This is, like, automatic 2 points because you jump off sides. But that was sick, you have to admit. That was sick. It was just, like, the way he caught that. But I knew that it was touchdown because he had high advantage.
Again as they come to the line to go for two.
What do I got?
And they'll turn to a power game.
Yep, that's 2 points.
And he will bull his way in there for the 2 points.
All right, Sengu, we just need one more stop, and we're done. We've won the Super Bowl. Right the confetti. One more stop. One more stop, D. This is four. Would you rather lose to a bitch ass pussy or become one?
That's fielded in the end zone.
It's just that simple. Oh, what happened? Oh. I feel, do you ever have that happen where you go back to the home screen? Like by an accident, you go back to the home screen. Like by an accident, like you just go back to the home screen. Or the PS home screen. My DualShock battery is low, my controller battery.
See if it's that easy.
All right,
here.
Yeah, well, you should be talking about the one.
Up here going with some tempo. Now a toss.
Oh, what play!
And he is going to lose yardage here. Call that a loss of 5 yards on the play. And some extras coming up on the line here, readying for the blitz. They'll toss it to Coleman.
Nowhere. Yes. Fourth down. What are you going to do? Look at the scoreboard.
And a cutback left and a crease here. Touchdown, Falcons.
Look at the scoreboard, though. That's all I care about. I miss this. Please just miss this. Please miss this. Oh, so close. So close.
set to go now with the kickoff. These two teams all even again as we continue in this wild fourth quarter. And no
fair
return
catch.
On this one as the fair catch is signaled for. And
but look at the scoreboard. We're tied, so you don't have any rights to talk. You don't have any rights to talk. So just shut up.
Last time out when they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it?
When you this play should be like money, but get it done again. We don't have the time. Oh, we didn't have the time. We didn't have the time. So,
yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go around. And that was incomplete, but I don't know how much of that.
I don't remember that. No.
He was pressured.
Brandon, the rush. Did he win that game? Or?
The quarterback had no chance.
No, I don't remember that. I don't remember anything. I don't remember about the.
They faked the handoff. Now Brady. He's got time in the pocket.
Be aggressive.
And he's unable to grab it.
We gotta score a touchdown this drive. This is like, who's the better Madden player right here? This is for all the marbles.
Because anytime you get a chance to take a big shot downfield,
just scoring though on fluky ways. All right, let's see if we can read this guy. Put this guy on a streak.
Throwing is Brady on third down, surveying the field. He's gonna take another shot.
Yes, Grant, you're an animal. Grant, you're an animal. God, you're an animal. No, that's the John Shunker we know, and that's the Andrew Hines here.
I think all the old rules about playing that position still apply.
Oh, he's wide open.
You're the best player out on the field. You still carry that supreme.
He's wide open. Come on.
And continue to fire the ball.
You know what? Let's run this ball. See what
we like this, and this is where you find out if you're great or not. Can you overcome some interceptions and still lead your team to victory?
Brady gives now to Bond. He'll get forward for three down to the 16-yard line.
We always like to talk about just defense. Let's go to 2 minute warning.
First level defensive line, second level linebackers, third level defensive backs.
No, I don't trust that.
That was what we call a first level run, and it was stopped by a second level player.
No, I'm not doing that. No. No. You think I'm gonna do that? No. I'm not. This is the Super Bowl. There are no rules.
On play action, now Brady looking for someone to throw to.
I dropped it down. Oh no! They may challenge that. Calm down. Oh no. Shit! I can't lose to a business pussy twice in a row. It's just not possible. I mean, that other like linebacker.
Following the fumble recovery, it's Ryan. And Jones has it over the middle. Now whistles blow and the Patriots are going to take another time.
Fuck! That was all yet. That was all yet.
This fourth quarter of play.
That was all yet. No. You had nothing to do with that. That's the John Shunker we know. I better hurry up. The game's almost over. Regulation's almost over.
Stopped on that play. We said plenty of carries all afternoon. Every now and then the defense is going
for all the marbles.
But I don't think they'll shy away from
handing it to him. All right, enough of that. All right, I need
it. They'll run it on the toss. And some room to roll now.
All right.
And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49.
I know anytime you watch a team run the ball really well, there's some pinball effect, people bouncing off of each other. There's also some things of beauty in there. You see these nice, explosive, strong runs. And this guy.
Now hang on here. Timeout called by the defense. It'll be their third and final timeout, so as they talk things over, we'll step aside. Here's Coleman on the toss. 9 yards on the pick up there as he'll be left with third and one.
You know what really fires up offensive linemen? When the guy that is carrying the ball behind them can create his own space and break a tackle along the way.
And they only need a little bit here. Third down and very short. It's Freeman. And he's going to get the first down here as he's taken down at the 22. A good pick up there of 20 yards.
Well, partner, that's one of the problems when you sell out to stop the run on third and short. Sometimes you break the initial wall and you go a long way.
So how do you prevent it?
That's tough to do. That really is tough to do. And one of the things offenses like to do nowadays in practice, you know, they do a lot of working against equal numbers. They'll start putting more and more numbers on defense and just telling the offensive guys, figure it out. Learn how to block it. We may see this situation.
Offense walks to the line for play number 7 of the drive. They come out here in the eye. Here's Coleman. Oh, he's got some breathing room. Cuts it, and he's in for the touchdown. And in the final seconds, forget overtime. They've just likely won this thing in regulation. A rushing touchdown, his 4th, puts him just 1 shy of the NFL record in a single game.
And we all know he would love to get to that record and even beyond it, but he doesn't need to in order to impress in this one, does he?
I mean, that's what a
performance. What an absolute great game that he's had here in this one.
That's fielded in the end zone. And with time a factor here late, he'll just take a knee and they'll start things out at the 25. Now the Patriots offense, they work their way back out onto the field. They have time here, partner, for just 1 final heave.
And I have to look at from the defense's perspective here. We know what they're going to do on offense. The Hail Mary, try and get guys down there and throw it in the end zone, tip it around and catch it. You've got to have guys back there to defend that.
Well, this is taken in. It's complete.
Oh, thank you.